In the name of Allah, the most gracious and the most merciful, this is the video of unit number 1, lesson number 1, observation and science, and for class 4. So let's see what this chapter has. It's one of the most important processes that all scientists have to go through to give a theory or a law, and we call this process scientific method or scientific process. This is actually a systemic procedure to give a law. It has around 6 to 7 steps, and it depends. But we are going to see each step one by one. So for the first step, we need 5 senses, that is sense of sight, sense of taste, sense of smell, sense of touch, and sense of hearing. So the first step is the observation, where you're going to study something using your 5 senses. You can observe things by watching their color, by watching their shapes, and by touching them, by smelling them. So it's the observation, that's the first step. Then the second step, you can see there's a boy who is thinking about something, and he is noting down all the problems he was trying to solve. So that is the second step, that is questioning. This is the step where you are going to collect the data from a reliable source. These reliable source can be book, a journal, from a scientist, or from the internet. This is the way you're going to solve or identify a problem. That's the second. That was the second step. The third step is the new word for you. That's hypothesis. Hypothesis is an educated guess. It's an intelligent guess, or a guess that can be testable or has a previous knowledge, right? So it's not a wild guess which is not testable and which has no previous knowledge. So it's an educated guess. Okay. So the fourth step is the prediction, in which you're going to tell in advance something, like forecasting weather. This is the prediction. You don't know, but based on the knowledge, based on your observation, you are saying that today is a chance of weather, of rain, because we have a lot of cloud in the sky. So there's a chance that rain might come. So this is how I'm predicting. I'm forecasting something based on the knowledge, based on my observation. That's the prediction. You are not going to say that today we have lots of clouds and today will be a sunny day. This is not prediction. For the prediction, you need some data. So that's the prediction. So what's the difference between an hypothesis and prediction? Well, casual hypothesis is a proposed explanation. A prediction is the expected result. So a proposed explanation is a hypothesis, or intelligent guess is a hypothesis, but the prediction is the expected result. So that's the difference between both of them. Then we have this is a person holding a syringe. That's the step where you're going to test all your data, all your observation in a laboratory. You're going to do experiments on it by using instruments that might be thermometer, telescope, microscope, a magnifying glass, and we have a lot of instruments in science now. So you're just going to test it with them, and when you get the result, if your result was the expected one, or if your result is a positive one, which means you were right, then it will be converted into a law or a theory or a fact. But if it's incorrect, then it's denied by the scientists, but still it will be usable. And the conclusion is the result. The definition of the result is: a conclusion is a short paragraph that discusses the overall result of an experimental procedure and explains whether the proposed hypothesis at the beginning of the experiment was correct or not. So if it's correct, then hooray, we have done a law or a theory. But if it's not, then don't mind, it's still usable. In science, we never deny something. And then the last step is to communicate your result to other scientists so that they could testify it as well, so that they could do their own observation on it as well.